Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Lord Forwind, here in Europa Universalis 4, playing as the Ottomans. So we actually have a marvelous game going right now. We have the Hejaz, Botan, and Georgia as our vassal. It's barely 1500, and I'm already planning on attacking Austria. Now, the question becomes, do I want to get an ally before I attack Austria? And do I want to attack Austria when I have no troops? Both are very good questions, which I don't actually have the answers to at the moment. I have started down the, I believe it's defensive, yes, the defensive tree. And I'm hoping to not go too much further down the religious tree at the moment, but rather get to the next idea group where I can get diplomatic tech. I was going to do influence, but in retrospect, the 20% morale from defensive is really good. The other option is to get on quantity and just have a huge horde of troops. Or offensive and have really good commanders. You know, I'll think about that more before I actually take it. The reason I want to do the military idea tree is because I'm ahead massively in military technology. Ships. I don't usually use ships as the Ottomans, so I'm actually going to go with reform the army instead, which is unusual and may not be a great decision. I mean, I do get 10% cheaper there. That was giving me 15%. Yeah. It's really useful, but I've never managed to ever really win a naval war, I guess. Not easy, to say the least. Timurids, okay. A long treaty with the Mamelukes. Ah, Austria has claimed one of our territories underhandedly. Even better. Not really. That's not good. Austria's caught up to us in tech level. Shoot. One of our generals just died. Let's get a new one before we lose any more of our army tradition. Well, if I lost them, it pretty much means I need to go down something into a military idea to give me a lot of combat strength. Best probably would be quality for the extra infantry combat. In the short run. In the long run, quality helps a lot. It would be really nice if the Janissaries would fire. 15% morale, though, is really useful as two. Ah, perfect, though. Austria just attacked France. Setting coalition as their cause, I bow. We're going to go with quality in this case. Mainly because if we go with quality, then the combat strength should make a difference in this war early on. Which means I actually should move to start this war while France has to deal with a huge coalition. I should have a claim on their province in a month or so. Still have a disloyal vassal there in Georgia. And the Protestant Reformation is firing. Circumstances are working out. Yes, gain the piety. I think I should be able to call Tunis to aid in the war, but we'll see. I really just want to break Austria's stranglehold on power. The HRE, and then just watch it go and explode. Okay, After into Austria we go. This could be good, could be really bad. Not sure which yet. We are attacking, looks like to be superior numbers. But I can call Tunis to the war. I don't know what Tunis will contribute, probably 11,000 troops. Or less. We'll see. Regardless, it'll be troops I never had to... I wouldn't have expected otherwise. I suspect they'll probably march all the way around, which means they'll arrive way too late to be of use. Let's hire a Janissary infantry unit. As much as I like sieging it down, their provinces down, I do need battles. The religious cause I vow. I'm hoping France can tie up Austria's armies for a while longer. What did France do? They must have taken land from Aragon and from Brittany at the same time. That's the only thing I can think of. It's a pretty big coalition against an AI nation. I've never really seen the AI nations do that in a long time. Maybe it's also kind of the 100 years war into it. If that's the case, then I'm seeing, you know, how it could work out that there would be that big of a coalition. Let's lower these forts. I don't think the AI will ever get to these ones. Although you never know, I've seen the AI snipe provinces like you wouldn't believe. Okay. We'll do this. Milan is hit level 9-2. Okay, that's worrisome because they actually have really good infantry. Ah, okay. Oh wow, that took forever for Granada to be defeated. That is very unusual, to say the least. Okay. Oh, I could just march up and start sieging the Austrian capital already. Bizarre. Okay. Oh, come on, Carnot. Kern-ten. Just fall already. Actually, I'm not gonna let you just reinforce your army willy-nilly here. You can actually cause you trouble. Plus, it's the Pope who's caught up to me in military tech, too. Where are my vassals? They are busy dealing with the rebellions. Okay. Not thinking this is turning out to be such a good idea here. Wasn't expecting them to, you know, instantly catch up in tech costs, so... Okay, first things first, smash that Austrian army. Oh my, I need a morale guy for sure. Oh, 12? Ugh, that's horrible. Oh, that hurts. I mean, I can afford him, but it's gonna bankrupt me. I do need the morale though. The war taxes should do it for the moment. It gets me up to 4 morale, which is good. I only have 35,000 troops though. It looks like I will catch them in Bosnia though. Ah, and since this is religious, I don't actually have to take territories. I just have to smash armies. So this could be doable if I play. Yeah, let's not go deal with the doom stack that I just saw wander through Austria. Ah, darn. That's not going to be a victory for me. Shoot. Retreat. Did we just steal one territory? No. Darn! That's going to be a problem. I'll merge those armies together for the moment. I'm going to have to go hunting the tiny armies that have wandered off on their own. Well, at least we'll get the 25% faster manpower recovery out of this. Don't think the Pope has level... Well, the Pope does have level 9 military. I think I can beat her. Yeah. Did that right. If they attack me, they should end up regretting it. No. Darn. Are they gonna force me to give them land and a peace treaty? Oh my gosh, they actually want my land. Huh. That's problematic. What? No. You don't run away like that. Oh, how annoying. They were sieging that, and I was coming to aid them, and now they bailed on me. Austria is ridiculous at this point. There's only one thing for it. I need to raise some troops. And I'm afraid mercenaries is the way it's going to be. Virtually free statesman that I can't use it, or in this case, stateswoman. Okay, if I do this right, I should be able to snipe at least one army. And it looks like the Papal army is the target in this case. That was unexpected victory that I hoped for but didn't expect. Austria still wants this fight. Wow. They must really want my lands. Who else do I have to worry about? Milan is weak. If I smash Milan, I might be able to get them to peace out. Actually, let's try and catch this Austrian army on their retreat. After all, it's battles won, not provinces taken. Could just do a white piece. I would really like that land. Okay, let's see if I can do this right. If I raise enough troops, I should be able to beat the Austrians in this fight. Especially if I smash their reinforcements before they even get there. Everybody against Austria in that one territory. Can I win it though? Ah, nope. I lost it. Shoot. Where did they get the reinforcements from? Oh, Milan showed up with more men. How annoying. Ah, sheesh. Big retreat. Okay. I don't want to know where my vassals are. They've seemingly ditched me in this war. Where are they? Are they like rebellious or something? Or are they just not here? They're just not here. Great. Papal states. They don't want to leave yet. Austria would accept peace, but I don't want peace. I want land. Mainly I want one of Austria's territories. Let's try and eliminate Milan from this fight. Oh yeah, I forgot they actually have pretty bad morale. No war exhausting line. Instead take out the Papal army again. Suspect France. Yep, France is still fighting onwards despite being surrounded and overwhelmed. Good for them. Yeah, take out that army. I want to take Cranes, and I can. I want to take the areas around Crane. The trick is to take one of the forts before they show up again. They still have troops. I don't want to fight them yet. I wish the Pope would just leave the war. Hurry up with sieging. We don't have a lot of time. There's their military. Oh, there's no ammo yet there in time. Guess it's worth a shot, though. If worse comes to worse, I can at least smash the remains of their army. 18th, we're getting there on the 20th. Oh, we'll win, but... such a crude way of doing it. They would just leave the war. I gotta be careful. If I sink too much more into this, I could easily be facing an invasion from the Timurids and the Mamluks. I think that's, yeah, it's just the Timurids and the Kora Klonalu right now. It's loans. Go France. France is fighting to the death. Hopefully Austria is death and not theirs. Come on, the Hejaz, your ally getting destroyed right next to you and you're sitting and watching. It's a bit annoying when you do that. Whoops. Okay, the Pope is out of the battle. Milan is gonna leave soon too. Next month, pretty much. Oh, actually, Milan is wanting to be in the war a bit more than I thought. Thirty-5,000 troops shy. Oh, that hurts. That'll do it. They have peaced out. Hallen Tate is very close as well to wanting to leave. Let's just deal with their last couple troops. And they will leave the war. Now it is just me and Austria. And if I did it, oh wow, that coalition. let's just demand two. Just one. That's a bit more manageable to size. On the other hand, I could take that and have them release those two provinces. Turn that to them. See, that would really weaken them. Plus, if I demand war reparations and some money. Yeah, that is a nasty blow to them. And a big win for me. Obviously, we're still. Why are you marching somewhere you don't have permission to? Okay. On that note, let's disband that entire mercenary army and mothball all those forts. Fire that advisor. Pick up the tax modifier one and the maintenance. And we're making money again. Good. We need a lot. We also need a lot more manpower as well. I'll take a level 2 advisor, mainly because she's 50% cheaper. How many mercenary regiments do we even have? A lot, to say the least. 34,000. Wow. We'll keep them around for now. Still rebellious over there, huh, Georgia? Ah, independence is supported by the Mamelukes. That would do it. That would certainly do it indeed. We just... I love how they're complaining about how we don't wage war, but we just did. And we lost all our claims on the Mamluk territory. So cancel that mission. Hopefully we'll get it again. Really? These guys can't stop causing trouble. In this case, we'll turn a blind eye for the moment. In exchange for some military support. Should give us army tradition boost. We'll still be negative in terms of their opinion of us, but eventually that'll tick up. Protestantism is a thing now. That'll weaken the HRA. The French apparently hate me. Bohemia likes me again. Do I want them as my ally is the question. They're peeing of Austria. Nothing great. Savoy is friends with me though. They wouldn't mind Austrian territory either. On the other hand, I am the Ottomans. I should be able to beat most of Europe in a single war on my own. Tech or idea? I'll take the idea for the prestige. That should allow me to lower my vassals' wish to run away. I hate that smuggler's event. So much money just wasted. Lower army maintenance for now. Paying off those loans is the first order of business at the moment. I'm going to stop improving relations with Georgia and instead work on improving relations with the Hejaz. I'd like to annex their land as well. Or to annex their land to start. Austria is apparently no longer a valid rival. Still in France would do nicely though. Tyrol here I release really likes me. As well they should. So anyone who opposes Castile and France should like me. Huh. Interesting. Let manpower recover. What a surprise. We'll take it. We'll fail almost inevitably because I'll start a war before then. Surprising, even though I stole territory from Austria, I didn't get that bad over expansion. I think mainly because I also released, three territories. Venice is... still hates me, but I'd much rather Venice than anyone else. They're at least killable. $600 a month. That is some nice army regen. The Hejaz are controlling their country once more. They went down influence as well. Interesting. Or I shouldn't say as well, because they went down it without me. Repay loan. Georgia has managed to stay Sunni this time. So good for them. What else we got? Trust with them. Trust with Tunis. Yeah, those are the only countries I'm allied to at the moment. It's a bit awkward when I stop and think about it. We already have powerful allies? You wouldn't really call the Tunis and Crimea powerful allies. I'm pretty sure Crimea has two troops. Moment. And my vassal Georgia is rebellious. Oh shoot, I just placed a rebel on. Well, that was dumb. That should save me like 70 admin power in the long run. Tunis, it's the Mamluks. I will do that. I will support them once more in these wars. I think I will not send my full military though. I'm not even sure I need to send my military. I do have two vassals. That should be enough troops to do a lot. So Ethiopia is attacking them. Guess I should smash the Mamluk army and seize Cairo. Or, you know, I can just sit back and, you know. But my vassals do half the work. I want Cairo, because if I let Tunis take Cairo, then I'm almost guaranteed I won't get anything from the war. Conquer Mesopotamia. That would be another war with the Timurids, wouldn't it? I don't really want to do that. Mothball all forts. 18 forts. I really gotta reduce the amount of forts I have. Problem is, these forts right here make a wonderful barrier against invasion from Europe. I need to climb to go kill them. Austria managed to hit a second level of reform, which is kind of amazing. I've only seen the AIs do that like once. I mean, I've seen them get to 3 before on the AIs, but that was when Protestantism didn't even occur in Europe. I think it was the Knights, Cyprus, in like Eastern Lithuania or something. It was the dumbest thing I've ever seen. I think not a single HRE province switched sides. Oddly enough, if I remember, the Protestant Catholic War League still formed. So maybe it was one of the electors did convert. Either way, it wasn't much. It's kind of a joke. That is a long time to convert. Don't want to attack the Timurids right now. Problem is, they look so juicy and conquerable. I'd have to go through Tabaristan first. We could do it, I guess. My manpower is recovering really fast. I Well, they did say I was going to get land from helping them in a war against the Mamelukes. Not entirely sure whether or not I believe the AI there, though. On the other hand, Tavarstan is nice land. Six years and I could take Austria. Might be worth waiting till I can attack Austria. Seriously, I am having trouble with the nobles. It's like the fifth event I've had with involving them. I don't want to attack them, I don't want to attack them. I would really like to attack Hungary, but then I have to fight Lithuania and the Pope again. Naples and Aragon are under Castile. Cercas is a vassal. Looks like Muscovoy died, or not died, but is not succeeding. Lithuania has gained quite a bit of land. Aha, look at this. Plus 25% cavalry combat ability in a single idea. That is a big shift. I think it is time to go mess around with the Timurids. Well, not Timurids, Tabaristan. Not even sure I'll have to send more than one army. Regardless of the fact, we have 10,000 manpower already built up. Whoa! They're turning out to be a bit difficult to kill. Let's talk to the merchants. I would love a contribution of some cash. Oh, okay, well, we got Alexandria out of this war. It's a nice gain, I guess. Oh, let's leave those two forts up. Marriage offer of Tunis. Tunis is doing okay now. I can start annexing Hejaz once this war is over. Georgia doesn't like me still. Iraq has apparently emerged as a nation though. Which we should be able to declare war on. I'm hoping Bohotan over here will go deal with them. Apparently not. Okay, well, I'll send my military. Actually, they are. Good. Good vassal. Good vassal. About time he did something. Technically, they're in March, I guess. Although I will say it's nice that they put up all the forts when you declare war, it does get a bit annoying when all you really want to do is attack. Royal Architect. I'm not building anything right now. We'll take the admin idea points. Anything closer to an admin idea is good. I suspect I can no longer convert Kabbalah though. Actually, I can, oddly enough. Oh, yes, I forgot. I can do that. I can threaten war. But I gotta be at peace to do that. Just thinking about it actually doesn't make sense. Okay. Actually, now I can easily convert that province. That province fell quickly as well. Okay. I just want those three provinces from you to Boston, and everything should go nicely for you. Good. Thank you for the land. It will be well used and not in your hands. Wow. Gillian actually costs a lot to core. Oh, might be the war exhaustion though. Silly corruption events. We need a Turkish one. We will refuse to even discuss compensation with them. Otherwise, we'd have to give them Alexandria, which I want because it's a trade node. Why are both my province forces suffering attrition? They're just not well-developed provinces. That would explain it. Whew. I'm thinking this would be a good stopping point. Yeah, 42 minutes. Again, another long video. But again, a lot of progress. So, think I'll end it there. Iraq will fall shortly, and then I'll move to attack Austria once more. And hopefully at Vienna. So, that will be it for this video, and I'll see you guys all next time. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did or have any advice, please leave something in the comments. I'll respond to virtually anything, as long as it's appropriate. Tactics are really useful. I mean, I'm pretty good at the game, I'm not that great though. So, bye for now. See you next time.